We're continuing to get you all the latest and live updates on the movement of Cyclone Tote. It's now been declared as an extremely severe cyclonic storm by the Met Department. So it's intensified further and it's currently inching towards the coast of Gujarat. The cyclone is heading towards the center of the southern bulge of Gujarat and is expected to make landfall near Diu by this evening. Mumbai, which is not in the direct line of threat of the cyclone, is however witnessing rains accompanied with strong winds as the cyclone moves north. Operation of Mumbai monorail has been suspended for the day. The BMC has also put out an advisory appealing to people not to venture out, particularly near the coast. According to the Met Department, moderate to intense spells of rain with gusty winds reaching up to 75 to 85 kilometers per hour is likely to occur at isolated places in Mumbai, Thane, Raigarh, Palghar, as well as Ratnagiri districts of Maharashtra. Ahead of landfall, as far as Gujarat is concerned, an earthquake measuring 4.5 on the Richter scale has hit Amreli district of Gujarat. However, no reports of any casualties coming in. The NDRF at this point has deployed over 50 teams in the state of Gujarat for evacuation and rescue. Nearly 1.5 lakh people have been shifted from low-lying coastal areas in Gujarat. Several states that have already borne the brunt of the cyclone. In Goa, unfortunately, two people have lost their life so far. Over 100 houses have been damaged due to strong winds. Several roads have also become inundated. In Kerala, the worst is over, but cyclonic winds did lead to damage of property. Heavy rains also caused waterlogging, particularly in parts of Alappuzha. Six people have lost their lives so far due to this cyclone, four in Karnataka and two deaths in Goa. And let me take this across to the DG of the NDRF, Mr. Pradhan, who's joining us. Mr. S.M. Pradhan is joining us on this broadcast. Sir, thank you for taking the time out and joining us here on India Today. You know, it's a difficult time for the NDRF in this kind of rescue operation because we're already dealing with the coronavirus crisis and amid that, this kind of a natural calamity. So how do you and how does your team really ensure that, you know, you abide by all the protocol as far as COVID appropriate behavior is concerned and yet at the same time save lives?
Well, I think you have hit the nail on the head. It was last year also when we were tackling Cyclone Samphan and Nisarg. It was during the time of COVID. COVID had just begun and I always used to call it a double whammy, a double challenge. I think the double challenge has now quadrupled in this case of pandemic, which is going very, very strong. So yes, it is a tough call, but NDRF is prepared for it. To start with, all the NDRF personnel have been double dosed with the vaccine, so they are well protected that way. They also observe a lot of protocols, including the outfit that they wear. You can see in the background the visual that I'm showing, which has them wearing full body suits. And that is the kind of preparation they have made, and they also observe a lot of other protocols of hygiene and safety. Because the principle is very, very simple, because this is the beginning of the season, and if at the beginning of the season more people from NDRF get infected, then it will have an impact on the rescue operations in the better part of the season, which has just begun. So yes, this is a challenge, and of course, as far as Cyclone Tote is concerned, we are all on ground now. The large teams which have to fly in have flown in from Nagpur, and in Gujarat, as you were saying, more than 50 teams, including SDRF, are already spread across Gujarat in the southern coastal districts. Mm. And since Gujarat is going to bear the brunt, the preparations are of a high order. And now that the Met Department has ruled that the at least on the sea, as the cyclone approaches Gujarat, it is going to turn into an extremely severe cyclonic storm category. And when it lands, it will certainly be a very severe cyclonic storm, which is something like 175 to 185 gusting speeds of wind. That is going to be a tough call, and we have to ensure that people are not in harm's way. That's why evacuations have begun since yesterday, and I think the preparations are going on well, and I should hope that we'll come out on the other side relatively with not major loss to life and property.
Mr. Pradhan, there have been a lot of comparisons between this cyclonic storm and Cyclone Nisarg, which had also hit the West Coast. The trajectory a little different, but is this a more intense storm?
It would appear so, because first of all, there are certain things unique about this cyclone. The first uniqueness is that this is after probably more than a decade that there is a storm in the western coast, and the season has begun with a storm in the western coast, which is very rare. Nisarg happened after Amphan. So normally the storm and the cyclone season begins in the west, in the eastern coast in the Bay of Bengal. So this is new. And second is that this is probably going to be an extremely severe cyclonic storm, at least on sea before it lands. And that is the category of Amphan. That again is rare, relatively rare, but with climate change, I think these are becoming common phenomenon. So this is, as I said, different from Nisarg. Nisarg was a very severe cyclonic storm, and if it lands as a very severe cyclonic storm, it would match the Nisarg speeds. But Nisarg, by the time it landed, it had it also lost velocity. I hope this is also the case with Cyclone Tote, but I don't think we should trifle with that. We cannot really bank on that. We should prepare for the worst case scenario, and that is what we have done.
Mr. Pradhan, you did mention that this is a double whammy of the coronavirus crisis plus this kind of a natural calamity. Have any state governments also reached out to the NDRF or the SDRF seeking help with regards to transportation, ensuring power supply to hospitals, ensuring oxygen supply is not disrupted as well, and transportation of COVID positive patients?
Well, the nodal agencies for oxygen supply, the safe transportation of oxygen and other essential requirements for COVID, the hospital management, etc., there are nodal agencies which are ascribed these functions specifically. Okay. But let me make it very clear that wherever NDRF is required and requisitioned, we are also helping, and we don't say no, because this is part of a disaster response. And in this disaster response, we don't say no. We never say no. We are there for the state administration, at the disposal of the state administration. And as long as we are there, whether it is response to the cyclone proper or the disaster proper, whether it is restoration work, whether it is COVID-relevant work, all that will be done as per the requirement of the state. And that is what we are doing. If at all the evacuation of hospitals are required, the jumbo hospitals have been evacuated in some of the states because the cyclone probably would have harmed them because they are not permanent structures. So all that we are helping, and wherever the help is required, NDRF is there to support the state administration and the district administration.
And finally, Mr. Pradhan, your advice to people who live in the areas that are going to be affected by the cyclone?
I think there is a very specific advice that I'd like to make, and that would be very clear advice: to evacuate. Even if you think that you are going to be safe in your house, which is probably in the path of the cyclone, I don't think you should assume that you will be safe. I would request all citizens who are in the impact districts and impact villages and impact towns, they should go to the safer places if requested by the local administration and as specified by the local administration. I don't think there should be any chances taken, because you don't take chances with nature. And suppose in the worst case scenario, the extremely severe cyclone which is building up in the sea does not turn downgrade into severe and continues to be extremely severe when it is landing on when it is making landfall. That will be in the excess of 190, 200 kilometers per hour, and that is a serious amount of speed, and that can damage even some Patna structures. So I don't think we should take any chances. So my request with folded hands to all citizens coming in the route of the cyclone, that they should evacuate as requested by the local administration and go to safer places as requested by the local administration. That would be a great thing that they would have done for themselves and for the community that they are living in and for the society in general.
All right, Mr. S.M. Pradhan, thank you very much for joining us. Very reassuring.